we know Chhattisgarh and tribal culture are two tautological terms, since a third of the state population is dominated by tribals. They account for 27% of Chhattisgarh's entire population. Right from independence, every government is trying to make them settle for their overall development. But it is the fate of irony that the issue couldn't take a right place. And it was as it was been. It is the past experience of last 5 decades that migration among the tribals in India has taken the form of tradition and practice in Chhattisgarh. After the completion of agriculture, work is after the completion of agriculture work in December and January, they migrate for big cities of India like Surat, Ahmedabad, Hyderabad, Jamshedpur, Bilaspur, Raipur in search of good jobs. But the problem is that our government is trying his best, but the result is sifar. Now, objectives of my paper. With the help of this paper, I am going to find out some of the remedies to highlight to root out the problem. Objectives are to look depth into the problem of migration among the people in national scenario, to find out the reasons of migration among the tribes of Chhattisgarh, to study the adverse effects of migration in socio-economic prospect, to find out a striking possibility to stop migration from rural areas, to inspect the implication of the remedies, to motivate the tribe to start their self-business. Now, what are the reasons behind migration? There are mostly two reasons. They are push factors and pull factors. Push factors are those factors that compel people to go out from their place. For example, failure of agriculture, problem of excess population, rapid growth of industrialization. And in Chhattisgarh, you must have heard, you must have seen in TV, at present, Naxali movement is going on in each and every part of Chhattisgarh. This is working as a push factor. That's why people are compelled to go out from their village. And each and every village, you can see a poster. And according to those posters, if you are doing this and this, then you will be so, dash, dash, dash. So these are some push factors. That's why people are migrating each and every year. And I think it's my own belief, it's my own experience that now migration has taken a kind of tradition to earn money. Generally what happens, just after reaping of the harvest, they go to Surat, Ahmedabad, Hyderabad to mint money, to buy some bike, to pay some loans, some debit. These are the reasons. Now we can talk on pull factors. Pull factors means the attracting factors. You can say that today the new generation, they are being much attracted with the people of Mumbai, filmy city. That's why they want to become heroes. They want to buy some new jeans, bikes. This is the fact, because I am a teacher in higher secondary school, and whenever some students, they don't come to school, I find out the reasons why he is not coming. I come to know that he has gone to Surat, Mumbai, and working in some factory. So this was the pull factor. Now, how to eradicate those problems? Problem is problem, and today you can't find even a single labor mazdoor in our area if you are in need. Even you are paying 300 rupees per day, there is nobody to do your work. That's why it's a very challenging thing. And for that, there are some suggestions. First of all, our government should start cottage and small industries in the rural areas so that they could stay there, number one. Number two is that development of transport and marketing. Generally, what happens if there is not the right means of transportation or good market, they sell their products in low rate, or they are not able to take their grains, food to the towns, to the city. And the third one is implication of government rules and what government wants to pay. So with the help of the factors, we can say that we can eradicate the problem of migration. Thank you very much.